With the influx of new jobs on the market, basically anything related to robotics is being sought after by young people. A broad field which has been in the public eye for a few years now and is only expected to keep growing is working in robotics engineering. Everyone sort of knows what it's about, but what if you actually want to pursue a career in it? What do you need to know? Well, the simple answer to that is you need to know a bit about everything. This is what differentiates working in the world of robotics from basically every other field of work. There isn't a clear path as to what you should and shouldn't study in order to succeed. Technically, this is true with everything if you think about it that way, but the majority of popular jobs usually have a somewhat clear pathway carved out for them. For example, if you're in school and want to become a doctor, then the things you have to do after school and during school are pretty clear. Robotics engineering is a bit more confusing. As has been highlighted by other sources, you can think of the job robotics engineer as a mix of computer science, electrical engineering, and mechanical engineering, with some aspects of psychology. An important thing to remember is that robotics is a world which is constantly expanding, and as such, you need to be conscious about these changes and constantly learning. This is important when studying. Rather than just applying yourself to one area of study, be open to learning as much as you can. For example, don't just limit yourself to the mechanical side of engineering because that's what you're committed on doing. Rather, also gain knowledge on the surrounding fields such as computer science and electronics. As with many jobs like this, university degrees are still relevant and sought after by potential employers as proof of knowledge. In fact, it's often expected that anyone going under the title of robotics engineer have a bachelor's degree in a relevant field, for example, mechanical engineering. And then following all of this, if you think you're viable for employment, there are several avenues you can go down. Apart from directly working with robotics, other options include embedded systems and working with intelligent devices. Intelligent devices is currently hot on the job market, which makes it the most attractive option for immediate return. However, the other aforementioned avenues offer pretty massive potential as well in the coming years, as both are growing exponentially. As everyone seems to obsess over how much they'll earn on average, jobs in robotics engineering will rake in about $80,000 annually, and that's in US dollars. Although being such a broad field of work, this varies massively depending on your skill level and employer, so an accurate number isn't really accurate. $80,000 is sort of like a middle ground. With all of these points in consideration, the question for people now will be, how do you even get started? And the answer lies in mathematics and physics. Focusing in on these two subjects while still at school, or just teaching yourself if you've already graduated, are the most important first steps towards this goal of robotics engineer. As maths and sciences form the basis of robotics engineering work, you will need sufficient knowledge to stand a chance in this industry, let alone succeeding in a bachelor's degree, which generally requires knowledge in both the aforementioned subjects. At the end of the day, anyone interested in becoming a robotics engineer should pursue it. Although the job at the moment seems somewhat average, the potential in the future is massive and is expected to grow exponentially.